Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. The whole Russia collusion mess is just getting more and more complicated. It's a tangled web of leaks and deceit. Caught up in all this intrigue is porn star Stormy Daniels and her attorney Michael Avenatti, along with Hillary Clinton and the Democratic National Committee. Today, DOJ official Bruce Orr is being grilled over the Trump dossier and ties to ex-British spy Christopher Steele. But an even bigger bombshell was dropped by a Republican congressman and it's a doozy. There's a new player in all this named FBI agent Jonathan Moffa. He's involved in this because he worked with former FBI officials Peter Strzok and Lisa Page. Page testified last Friday behind closed doors before the House Judiciary Committee and House Oversight Committee, where, according to Fox News, a source with knowledge of his statements confirmed to Fox News that Moffa said FBI personnel would use media reports based on information they leaked to justify applications for Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act warrants, FREP. Mark Meadows is behind that bombshell and its allegations, it seems. We've learned new information suggesting our suspicions are true. FBI, DOJ have previously leaked info to the press, and then used those same press stories as a separate source to justify FISA's, House Freedom Caucus Chairman Mark Meadows, RNC, tweeted overnight. That new information came from Moffa and it's huge in its implications here. What we have here is a case of circular reporting. Comey and the FBI would leak fake news, which had to do with a bogus Trump-Russia dossier. Then the media would run with the news. The FBI would then use those same articles as proof to justify a FISA warrant. They would allegedly claim it was necessary evidence to get their warrants approved by a judge. We've learned new information suggesting our suspicions are true. FBI, DOJ have previously leaked info to the press, and then used those same press stories as a separate source to justify FISA's trending. Sarah Sanders just shared surprising update after McCain banned Trump from his funeral. Unreal. Tomorrow's Bruce Orr interview is even more critical. Did he ever do this? Mark Meadows, but read Mark Meadows, August 28, 2018 from Fox News. The claim stemmed in part from FBI intelligence analyst Jonathan Moffa's Friday testimony behind closed doors before the House Judiciary and Oversight Committees. But what exactly Moffa told the committees is a matter of dispute. A source with knowledge of the testimony initially told Fox News that Moffa said FBI personnel would use media reports based on information they leaked to justify applications for Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act warrants, echoing Meadows. The source said Moffa, who worked with controversial former FBI officials Peter Strzok and Lisa Page, acknowledged this had been a practice in the past, but an FBI official pushed back, telling Fox News the initial claims about Moffa's testimony were incorrect. The source later clarified that Moffa testified the FBI routinely uses media material to corroborate their work product, including FISA materials, but never said directly, "We utilize FBI leaks for FISAs." The source maintained, however, that the FBI has a culture of leaking for their own gain and uses media reports to support their work. There's quite a bit of evidence raising concerns that the FBI engages in this without Moffa saying it. Jonathan Moffa made it clear to the committee the FBI routinely uses media reports to corroborate analytic work product. We have emails and texts plainly showing the FBI leaks to the media, raising major red flags. If FBI executives want the American people to believe they haven't used leaks to their advantage, they are not being honest, Meadows made clear in a statement while saying this includes FISA materials. Meadows also told Fox News, America's newsroom, earlier Tuesday that the committee had evidence of the FBI's practice that would be hard to refute. We know that some people at the Department of Justice and the FBI actually gave information to the media, then the stories were reported. Then they use those reports to justify further investigations, Meadows said. You know, that's like saying, we're going to incriminate on one hand, and be the jury on the other. It just doesn't work that way. I guess we'll have to stay tuned on that one. We know that Clinton and DNC money helped pay for the dossier, but who brought Stormy Daniels into all of this? It seems that Hillary potentially has a special relationship with Stormy of some sort. Michael Avenatti is tied to both Stormy Daniels and Hillary Clinton. He's also tied to the DNC and is saying he will run for the presidency in 2020. All of them have been connected to each other for a long time, it would seem. Avenatti also seems to have connections with the Chalupa sisters, Alexandra and Andrea. They have been linked to pro-Ukrainian groups, and it's alleged that they have leaked fake news to smear President Trump as well. On July 2, 2017, Andrea Chalupa tweeted, "Same sources told me last year's Manafort was under federal investigation and there was a Trump sex tape. I mentioned both on Twitter before news broke. If true, it would indicate that the Chalupa sisters are deeply involved in all of this somehow. I have never heard of them before." Pictured below is Michael Avenatti with Alexandra Chalupa. She is two Avenattis, right? Makes sense when folks understand Alexandra Chalupa wasn't just Clinton's princess to plant at DNC to scream Russia. She designed multiple Trump opposition plans and now, voila, stripper team unite. Miss me, at Dontelionu, August 28, 2018. Bloomberg is reporting, Adam Parkhomenko, a former DNC staffer who was the co-founder of Ready for Hillary, which encouraged Clinton to run before 2016, helped connect Avenatti with reporters at the party's meeting. Alexandra Chalupa, a Democratic consultant, introduced him to meeting attendees. Seems pretty cozy if you ask me. Maybe someone should look into those connections. In the end, every one of these tangled pieces of information has one thing in common: Hillary Clinton. I don't believe in coincidence, do you?